This story is about the sterilization campaign launched by India's ruling regime during the emergency period 1975 to 1977. Sterilization is a surgery to make someone unable to produce offspring. In India, mass forced sterilization campaign spearheaded by Sanjay Gandhi, son of Indira Gandhi. The title "The Free Radio" is a compensation for the act of humiliation. The free radio refers to an incentive. The gift of a transistor radio the health department gave to those undergoing the sterilization surgery or vasectomy. Here are some important questions from this story. Discuss about the narrator and narrative technique, character of Ramani, portal of the widow, historical and political context, theme of dream and reality. You have to touch this topic while analyzing Ramani's character. Before going to the text, we will learn a little bit about the author. Salman Rushdie is an Indian-born British-American novelist and essayist. He was born in Mumbai on 19 June 1947. Rushdie has had a string of commercially successful and critically acclaimed novels. His second novel, Midnight's Children, is a fable about modern India. Same, which was published in 1983, is about contemporary politics in Pakistan. The Satanic Verses is his most controversial work, was published in 1988. This book is now banned in India. Characters of the story. The narrator, who is a retired schoolmaster. Ramani, the protagonist, a good-looking young man who is a rickshaw puller. The thief's widow. Her name is not mentioned anywhere in the story. Later, she got married to Ramani. One day, Ramani was roaming around the town without a passenger, and the thief's widow had gone to the baniya shop with her 5 children. Then she called a rickshaw. Obviously, that was Ramani. The narrator was watching all the things. He thought, "Careful, my son, or you will have this burden to pull for all of your life." After that day, Ramani and the thief's widow were seen everywhere. Sometimes in those days, Ramani with his friends drink illegal liquor. Those friends always flattered Ramani by comparing him with Shashi Kapoor and Amitabh Bachchan, who are the big stars of Bollywood. They did it because they knew that they could take money from him by flattering him. Thus, Ramani's head became filled with these movie dreams. The narrator blames the widow for not stopping Ramani from having these unrealistic dreams. The next day, when the widow came to the baniya shop, the narrator asked her to stay away from Ramani. Or it would be better for her to go to any widow ashram in Benares and thanking God that the widow burning is not legal. By hearing this, she gets very angry and tells the narrator that Ramani wants to marry her, but she does not agree because she does not want any more children. At this time, a white caravan arrives in the town where men were taken every night for vasectomy. And one day, Ramani suddenly began to talk about a special gift from the central government, that is a first-class, brand new, battery-operated transistor radio. I have said at the beginning of the video that the central government had started a sterilization campaign to bring the population under control, where a free radio was given as compensation. Here, Ramani is talking about that free radio. Just a few days later, Ramani married the widow. Now the narrator realizes that the widow has convinced Ramani to have vasectomy so that she can marry Ramani. But there is no mention in the story that did the widow convince Ramani to have vasectomy or Ramani did it himself to marry the widow. One day when he met Ramani, the narrator asked him if he had gone to the caravan. Then he replied, "I am in love, teacher sahib, and I have made it possible for me to marry my woman." When the narrator gets angry by hearing this, Ramani says that Nasbandi does not stop love making, it stops babies only, and his woman did not want children anymore. And soon he will get a free radio. This time the narrator got very angry and asked Ram to leave, because he knew that government would not give any more free radio. After these events, the thief's widow, who is now Ramani's wife, did not come into town very often. Ramani worked longer hours than ever before, and every time when he saw anyone, he told about the radio and mimicked radio broadcast. 1 year has passed. Still, Ramani did not get any free radio, but he continues his mimicry. And then the white caravan came back to the town. One day Ramani goes to that caravan to get his free radio. But his drinking champs, who were the guards of the caravan, beat up Ramani and drive him out. Some days after the incident at the caravan, Ramani sold his rickshaw. He comes to United to say goodbye and says he is going to Bombay to be a bigger star than Shashi Kapoor and Amitabh Bachchan. And he says that his wife and children will also come with him. A few months later, the Nata receives a letter from Ramani that stating how his life is going on in luxury in Bombay. But the Nata does not believe in Ramani's letter. The letter remembers him how Ramani used to tell his radio story to everyone before he got the radio and how he reacts after knowing the truth about the free radio. The story ends in a very beautiful way where it remains in a mystery whether Ramani succeeded in Bombay or not.